rich, would you live like the Garahans did too? Moot point, I guess. This place is impressive, huh? Well, the Garahans rode high on their mining cash for a long time. Not that it got them anywhere in the end. You got that right. Though, sometimes I wonder if going on living like this is a blessing or a curse. Hard not to be nostalgic for a glitzy past when you have to carry on looking like I do. Anyway, I don't know if you want to listen to an old lady reminisce, but I'll be camped out here for a while. It's a stroll down memory lane. I'll tell you what I can. I did. And better than a lot of people, in fact. I worked at Garahan HQ before the war. A receptionist. I got to know some of the higher-ups pretty well. Get in with people like that, and you get invited to a cocktail party or two. I have mixed feelings. They lived a life of luxury up there, built on the backs of those hard-working miners of theirs. On the other hand, they paid my salary and were friendly enough in person. I wasn't exactly slaving away in the pits either, so how resentful can I be? Especially now that I'm alive and they're long gone. I was lucky. I hid. And when those red monsters showed up, I fled east. But the coast is bad. Very bad. It was hit a lot harder than home was, so when people started flooding back, I came back as well. I wasn't unscathed, of course. I became what I am today. A ghoul. And that hasn't made life any easier. Well, for one thing, you're never given the benefit of the doubt. Something stolen? Instant suspect. I guess it's hard to keep an open mind about someone that looks like they'd eat you at the first opportunity, but it's still frustrating. But the worst part? Every time you see one of those feral monsters, you wonder, what separates them from me? Will that be me someday? That's hard to live with. Sure. Anything else? Suit yourself. I'm gonna live in the husk of luxury for a little bit longer. Now the world above is as dangerous as the world below.